And 2020, COVID happened. But just before the lockdown, you shut down Roast and Ryme.
Cassie with their band is speed but controlling the scene with dot no remote. I have champion and now we go. I've been around before my concert. Now go, you're good, my son. Sing a beat and I fuck up all the situations.
I was there. I enjoyed a good time. And for me, I think I've watched you perform a couple of times, but that day it was quite different from the way you understand. I don't know, I think you've performed with that band before.
Yeah.
You guys understood each other, but you could take us through that experience. How did it feel? What was going through your mind when you stepped on that stage?
To be honest, before you step on stage, there's a little nervousness, like you're like, will I lose my voice? Will I do too much? Exactly. It's a big crowd. You have to remember every single line. And most of my songs are technical. I do not have songs like so many of my fellow artists. My fellow artists don't have technical songs. My songs are too technical. So since the songs are too technical to a certain extent, you find that you have to always remember every line. Because you're looking at songs like Chupa Kuchupa, they have like four verses. Just imagine if you're on verse one, and instead of going to verse two, you go to verse three. You know? So much is running through your head, but at the same time, you have to be cool and composed and know that your mind is capable of remembering all this stuff. So for me personally, when I stepped on that stage, it was beautiful. First of all, it showed me a lot. Whenever I look back, I'm like, yes, I'm improving on my stage performance and stage presence, because that's one of the parts that has been weak in my music journey, to be honest, because it's not easy to actually perform on stage. It's not the easiest thing, because you're thinking about a lot of things. You're saying, okay, I'm gonna make this dance move, but what if people don't like it? I'm gonna do this, but what if that? But I lost myself. I said, let's just be myself. Let me just do my thing. Let me have my swag. Let me move how I have to move. And I think it's one of the few shows where I was very, very composed and comfortable with the show. Besides the shows I also do like outside Uganda, like let's say in the UK, a couple of shows I've done. But I felt love in the audience, and I also kept myself composed. And that experience was amazing. I thank the guys at Swangs for Roast and Ryme. I think the platform is amazing, first of all. It's very good to showcase people singing live. It's not easy. Singing live is like creating music in the studio. But on the next level, you have to sing everything. And it's back to back, song upon song. You're hearing, let's say you hear like one of the instruments that excites you the most is not put up above for you to hear it. Well, you can't hear it, but you still have to perform. You have to go on. So it's crazy being on stage. It's really crazy being on stage, but it's amazing. The vibe that you get and the energy to sing for people, because music is a service. So serving people, for me, I feel like it's really special, and it brings a certain energy. After leaving the stage, coming into the fans, saying hello to them, it's just beautiful. It's just beautiful. For me, the experience was amazing.
Yeah, and that same day you performed before you, Azawi performed as well. And that was her very first performance since coming to music.
Yes.
I think she did well.
Yes.
Of course, I would like to know, what does a platform like Roast and Ryme, that big stage, family day, so many people up to like where the lake starts from, what do these kind of concerts add to an artist? For example, a new artist like Azawi was at the time.
Yes.
What do they learn from it? What impact is it to the artist?
For me, in my understanding, I think it's an eye-opener for the artist to see the magnitude and the level at which they have to perform. Because you're going to see other people who have done it, you know? You're going to see other people who have done it, and you're going to look at yourself and see what you've done as well. And say, you know what, this is what I'm meant for, or this is what I'm not meant for. Because it just gives you an understanding. Being on stage is crazy for a young artist, because I know what it means to be a young artist going on stage, and you're new, you've never done it.
And there are thousands of people.
And there are so many people, some don't know you.
Yeah.
You know, they're not so excited as much as you think they should because they don't know you yet. You know, your name is okay, buzzing, but they don't really know you that much. But it's crazy. But having that, I think for Azawi, it's beautiful because she's under good management, first of all. Those people know what they're doing. And on top of that, she's grounded and she loves music. So it's an opportunity. It was an opportunity for her. I hope to see her on the next roster rhyme, you know, just to see her perform all her songs because most of her music is amazing to me. I've had the chance to be part of her album. And I've seen how she loves music and the energy she has in studios. She's beautiful. And for me, I believe every young artist who gets on that stage should be very thankful. Let them not look at the money, let them look at the experience and what they can actually extract from that show, the energy, the footage, and all that. Just to look back and say, okay, I should have improved here before I got on stage. Oh, I didn't improve on that part, but that's a part I want to look at. This is what I want to look at. I think it's a very good place to go to evaluate yourself, but it's also a very big platform which can actually put you down. But you should never be put down. It's all lessons. You don't lose, you learn.
Personally, how do you prepare for a concert, for a show, for a performance?
For a performance?
How do you... Because I've been close to a few artists, yeah. And man, what is it, the culture? It's, they do different things.
They have rituals in
rituals,
a sense.
Yes. Uh-huh. How do you prepare your performance?
Me? I'm always listening to the songs I'm supposed to perform continuously. I have like a playlist of every song I'm going to perform, and I just listen to it continuously and sing. Because repetition helps you remember every line. If you don't repeat the stuff, it can be crazy. You get on stage and you forget words. You start telling people, "Banange muyimbe, sing, people sing." But it's you who has been paid to sing. It's not the people to sing, it's you. And for me, when I look at shows like that, there is a lot that you have to do. So for me as an artist, before I even think of going to stage, is to listen to the songs weeks before. Second thing is to actually have my mic, because I don't want to start complaining, saying, oh, they brought a fake mic here, this didn't work here, that did. Nah. Let me come with mine.
Oh, you go to stage with your own mic.
With my own mic.
That white mic.
It's a golden one. It's a golden,
yes,
yeah, golden one. So basically that's what I would do. The other thing is that I make sure I do sound check. I make sure I do rehearsals, whether I have to do them at home and just go through the songs, whether I have to do rehearsals, let's say with a band, I make sure I don't skip any rehearsal because it's important for you to be in sync with the band. The band will play something when they are going into a transition and you don't know it. You get caught off guard and start looking angers, like a dog that has dropped a metal. Translate that to Luganda. I don't know if you'll even manage. Those who don't know. So you don't really want to be in such a... You don't want to be in a predicament like that. But for me, looking at that, you need to look at all those things prior to the show. Make sure you do the rehearsals and make sure you do sound check and get your levels right. You'll get on the stage and start shouting for two songs, and the next five songs you've lost your voice, you can no longer sing. So you have to pace yourself, and that's another thing I had to learn, you know. And even talking to other artists like Dexter Dubs, like so many artists talk to, and they tell you, man, just pace yourself. That's how you do it, because you can sing and just go way above the level you should sing at, and you lose your voice and you won't be able to go through the whole performance. The voice is now done. So for me, I think that is one thing that artists have to look at a lot. Drink a lot of water. Have water, even if it's on stage. No, not the waraji, not all that. People don't need that. So many people think they need it, but they're destroying their voices.
Actually, yeah, you talk about that. So many artists say that I have to puff.
Yeah, they need to smoke some weed. They need to drink and get high.
For motivation.
It's not motivation. They lack confidence. And they should be confident within themselves. You don't need a drink to be confident. You need to look at yourself and make yourself more confident. You know, make yourself more confident. When I put on suits, because I love them, when I meet people in a nice suit, with a nice perfume, with a nice shoe, with a nice watch, that I don't miss much, my friend. You know? Like the person looks at you and they're like, yes, this man. And you feel confident within yourself going to people when you're a certain way. And I think artists should prepare themselves that way, not prepare yourself by drinking.
Yeah.
Because you may forget your lyrics. Something will happen if you just really go off and then you don't know how and what to do. It becomes a problem. It's actually a bigger problem.
We've actually seen some of those performances.
Exactly. These things happen all the time. I see them even on some of the shows. I go, someone is just looking different. It's not them. They can't even sing their voice. They are very shaky. And you don't need that. You have to have a clear mind. So I think a lot of water is important for you. You drink, go on stage, have your energy, eat well. Go on stage and enjoy yourself. Have fun.
Awesome. That's Apass. And of course, that leads me to the other thing. Roast and Rhyme is happening on 27th February. That's this Sunday. So that's at Jahazi Pier, courtesy of Belgium's Songs Avenue and a host of other sponsors. So book your tickets online and be there.